This is the Zero Hour calling in the Pacific. And for the next 75 minutes, we're going to take you through music as you like it, sweet and hot and otherwise. Music from all over the world and a thought for the day. Sometimes even two thoughts for the day. First, let's have the fighting news for the fighting men.
Although the bulk of the fighting on the Western Front is still in the area between Dives and Saloon Rivers, the center of gravity of the Allied offensive at present is more massed than before in the mobile wing of the American Army, operating between Normandy and Loire. He has been trying to accomplish a breakthrough between Orne and Dives. The Allied pressure in Normandy was brought to bear partly with the intention of tying down the bulk of the German counter thrust in the area south of Seine Bay. The 3rd United States Army pushed forward its motorized spearhead with strong air force support from middle of the south eastward in order to cut off the German communications. The American units from Nantes and Angers appeared to be moving forward towards Loire. In Brittany, the Allies redoubled its efforts to take the fortified coastal places. Fierce fighting is going on for Lorient and off Brest. In Saint-Malo, the German garrison is continuing to offer heroic resistance. There was no noticeable change in the battle line between the Saloon River and the area south of Vire. The battle continues north and northeast of Falaise. Here, Canadian attacks were met by German troops with stubborn resistance. In Italy, no major operations took place on Saturday. On the Eastern Front, the several Soviet attacks between Koch and the Big Vistula Bend were warded off and numerous Soviet tanks destroyed. The Luftwaffe carried out several successful raids on Soviet tank columns west of Baranov. Northwest of Bialystok, further breakthrough attempts by more than Soviet divisions were checked in a grim battle, as were all Soviet thrusts in Latvia. Southwest of Lake Pleskow, on the other hand, the Soviets succeeded in enlarging their penetrations. On the Indo-Burma front, the Japanese forces inflicted tremendous blows on the enemy troops of over 30,000 in battles around Mitikina. Within a period of 5 months up to the end of July, the enemy suffered the loss of more than 15,000 men, including those killed, wounded, and taken prisoner. In the Pacific, our garrison on Chichijima Island in the Ogasawara repulsed on Saturday an enemy formation of 16 four-engined bombers, which came to raid the island. At dawn the same day, 16 enemy fighters attempted to raid Wotji Island in the Marshalls, but were beaten back by our interceptors.
You have just heard the fighting news for the fighting men. This is the Zero Hour calling in the Pacific.
Heard about the trouble we had, boss?
What trouble?
You remember Frank Watanabe?
Yeah, we had him Saturday.
Well, he was on again last night.
How come?
He busted right in on the news.
You're not allowed. That's against the rules.
Well, that went out anyway.
Hey, Gus, sit up on the bed. In the meantime, we bring you Anne and her playmates, the orphans.
Fighting orphans of the Pacific. How's Trix? This is after her weekend, Annie, back on the air strictly under UN hours. Reception okay? Well, it better be, because this is all request night. And I've got a pretty nice program for my favorite little family, the wandering boneheads of the Pacific Islands. The first request is made by none other than the boss. And guess what? He wants Bonnie Baker. And my resistance is low. My, what taste you have, sir, she said. Thank you. Oh, but my resistance is low. You say that you love me truly, but then you proceed to act so unruly. I ought to say no, I'll make you let me go. Oh, but my resistance is so low. I used to dream of a true love, of what you're so sweet and so divine. Oh, but you've brought me a kind of new love, and it's taken full possession of my mind. I like to go to dances, or a movie with you, but you just wanna park the car and fix your little room. I ought to say no, make you let me go. Oh, but my resistance is so low. My mother always tells me a kiss is all right, when it's dark and after 12 and you turn off the light. I have to say no, make you let me go. Oh, but my resistance is so low. And now that hat will be passed. The second request is sent in by a roaming bonehead of an orphan, request number 29. He wants Tony Martin, of all people, to help him forget the mosquitoes and dirty rifles. Well, you know, obliging Annie, Tony Martin, and Now It Can Be Told.
Wash day for some, rustle cleaning for some, and for the others, just another day to play. Let's all get together and forget those wash day blues. Here's Kay Kaiser, Sally Mason, and all the playmates So come join the parade, you bonehead.
Don't make a sound, not even a happy.
Baby's asleep. Ah,
he's awake. Must be dinner time.
I see Betty's getting impatient with her request of the evening. Oh, come on. Don't hold back, Betty. What is it you want to hear?
Don't be bashful. Sure.
Can you oblige with my heart belongs to Daddy? Bee Wade doing the vocal, of course.
Well, no sooner said than done.
While tearing off a game of golf, I may make a play for the caddy. But when I do, I don't follow through, 'cause my heart belongs to Daddy. If I invite a boy some night to dine on my fine Finn and Hattie, I just adore his asking for more, but my heart belongs to Daddy. Yes, my heart belongs to Daddy. Couldn't be bad. Yes, my heart belongs to Daddy. Da 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 da. So I want to warn you, laddie, though I know you're perfectly swell, that my heart belongs to Daddy, 'cause my daddy, he treats me so well.
Is a hero man to show off the other side of his character by requesting languid Eddie Howard singing, "Now I Lay Me Down to Dream."
Now I lay me down to dream of you. Sighs of another day, and on the very day it's true. Now I lay me down to dream of you. In just a moment, yeah, I'll dream and you'll be here. My endless nights are so lonesome. My endless memories remain, and every dawn I awaken, feeling your name, but all in vain. So I lay me down to dream of you. And as I close my eyes, I'll pray the spring comes through. down to dream of you. And as I close my eyes, I'll pray this dream comes true.
According to Union Hours, we are through today. We close up another chapter of sweet propaganda in the form of music for you, for my dear little orphans wandering in the Pacific. There are plenty of non-unionists coming around the corner, so we'll be seeing you tomorrow. But in the meanwhile, always remember to be good, and so...
Goodbye now.
Goodbye.
Goodbye now.
Goodbye.
I thought the party was divine. I spent the evening forgetting the time. I can't deny, and now goodbye. Goodbye now.
Goodbye.
Goodbye now.
Goodbye.
The trip by taxi wasn't far. We'd linger longer if I had a car. No use to cry, and now goodbye. There's one advantage to our leaving. It brings about a special kiss. I hope that this may be eternally a momentary parting, just a second, then we're starting. So goodbye now.
Goodbye.
Goodbye now.
Goodbye.
It's just a moment we're apart. To make it certain, I'll leave you my heart. But for now, it's just goodbye now.
Pacific. We've just had it sweet, and in a moment, we're going to have it hot. But in the meantime, here are your news highlights.
Honolulu was alive with rumors, all of them wrong. It was rumored that the closely guarded Navy command where the president stayed would be the site of a meeting with Churchill or Chiang Kai-shek or both. Actually, the whole affair was an American huddle. To a reporter who asked the president about an Anglo-American meeting, Roosevelt replied that Churchill is not in Honolulu, nor has he expected in Waikiki. A Churchill conference, he said, is a question for future determination. Roosevelt said he will report to the nation on his Pacific trip, his first war journey. He said he has no time for political campaign in the usual sense, but said that he would report to the people from time to time. Roosevelt ordered the seizure of Midwest truck companies involved in an 8-day strike, and that they will be operated by the Office of Defense Transportation until the dispute is settled. The War Labor Board, which found itself powerless to solve the controversy in which 108 companies refused to pay a directed 7 cents an hour wage increase, and 25,000 drivers went on. One whole day was spent on the fire that licked the Hudson River Pier at New Jersey. Firemen still battled the flaming wave Saturday night. Police and officials of the fire department now announced that the damage exceeded millions of dollars. The dockmen suffered minor injuries while battling the fire. The police department reports that the fire started from one of the drums when one of the drums of the oils which were being loaded caught fire. Uh-oh, Army practice bombers dropped something on the ground in Florida when the mechanical releasing device suddenly went haywire. The planes on practice bombing mission dropped several bombs which fell behind the target. And what do you think happened? 4 civilians were killed and 5 others injured. Well, what can you expect in this day and age? The Australian war brides have arrived in San Francisco, forming the largest contingent of Australian wives of American servicemen. There were 296 wives carrying 72 babies. Australian sources have announced that there's plenty more, a larger number than there were in 1942. Already some 200 babies of these brides have traveled to the United States. Another batch of 134 brides are awaiting transportation, and 200 others have applied for permits to enter the United States.
I have just heard the news highlights for tonight. This is the Zero Hour calling in the Pacific. We've had it sweet, and now...
Hey, boss, what are we going to do about Watanabe?
Have you received any protests from the International Red Cross?
That's just what I'm worried about.
Better be careful next time he's around. And hello again to American fighting men in the Pacific. Once again, the Music from Home man brings you swinging music for syncopating smoothies. There's that old theme song again, and I know that you know, so let's get together again and get associated. Drop everything, easy there, and lend an ear to the music. These are the familiar tunes that were part of your landscape back in those years of 1940 and 41, and when you hear them again, perhaps you can remember one or two of the little things that used to make life worth living back in those times. And here's our first one. Sing along with Helen Forrest and swing along with Goodman. Sing like one of those little meadowlark things. Are you ready?
Thank you.
Benny Goodman lifts his baton again.
And still once more we hear the voice of our enchanting chantress, Helen Forrest, chanting her song of love to the starry night. The Fable of the Rose.